Let us bring our attention to the following chart. Now, before I proceed, what this chart measures is acetyl-L-carnitine levels in the blood plasma in regard to each particular group. Now, you'll notice the dashed line, that is the mean of the acetyl-L-carnitine in the blood plasma for each corresponding group. Now, this is a biomarker. We're not stating yet that acetyl-L-carnitine may be an effective treatment for major depressive disorder. However, animal studies are extremely promising. Yet, before I proceed, human studies have to be conducted. Dosages, amounts, and of course, is it going to be as effective in humans as it has been in animals? So with that in mind, let's look at the chart. All right, we're looking at right there, as we stated before, is the dashed line is the mean of the acetyl-L-carnitine levels in the blood plasma. Healthy control groups, notice at the highest amount. The major depressive disorder with non-treatment-resistant depression, lower. And that lower yet, we have individuals with treatment-resistant depression itself. You notice the correlation between the acetyl-L-carnitine as a biomarker for each particular group. With this particular chart in mind, let us get right into the research as it is published as follows. Depression linked to low blood levels of acetyl-L-carnitine. People with depression have low blood levels of a substance called acetyl-L-carnitine, according to a Stanford University School of Medicine scientist and her collaborators in a multi-center study. Please forgive me, I have to speak a little fast because we have a lot of ground to cover and I want to try to get it in within 7 minutes or so. So with that in mind, let's proceed. Naturally produced in the body, acetyl-L-carnitine is widely available in drugstores, supermarkets, and health food catalogs as a nutritional supplement. People with severe or treatment-resistant depression or whose bouts of depression began earlier in life have particularly low levels of the substance. Again, acetyl-L-carnitine. All right, we're going to skip to the Science Daily, which did a little more technical report in regard to the study itself, and they have a good excerpt here. In the latest study, the scientists measured levels of LAC, representing acetyl-L-carnitine, in blood samples taken from people diagnosed with major depressive disorder. They found that levels were significantly decreased in these patients as compared to age-matched individuals without depression, hence that chart we looked at. Additional analysis revealed that the patients with very low levels of LAC, acetyl-L-carnitine, exhibited more severe depression and were more likely to develop major depressive disorder early in life. Finally, the researchers found that the decreased LAC was associated with having a history of childhood trauma and treatment-resistant depression, particularly in women. All right, so there we have an interesting biomarker. Now, about the promise in regard to research. In this case, we're going to refer to an animal study, or the researchers refer to some of the animal studies in regard to LAC. Again, this is not a recommendation of dosage or amount or even it works in humans as yet. This is promising, yet the trials have to be conducted in humans in order to validate. In rodent experiments led by Dr. Nasca, hope I'm pronouncing that appropriately, both here at Rockefeller and elsewhere previously, deficiency of acetyl-L-carnitine was associated with depression-like behavior. Oral or intravenous administration of acetyl-L-carnitine reversed the animal's symptoms and restored their normal behavior. In those studies, the animals responded to acetyl-L-carnitine supplementation within a few days. Current antidepressants, in contrast, take 2 to 4 weeks to kick in animal experiments as well as among patients. So there you see a similarity between the animals and the humans in regard to treatment with basically the antidepressants and with the experimental acetyl-L-carnitine. Nasca's animal study suggests that acetyl-L-carnitine, a crucial mediator of fat metabolism and energy production throughout the body, plays a special role in the brain where it works at least in part by preventing the excessive firing of excitatory nerve cells in brain regions called the hippocampus and the frontal cortex. That's hypothesis and possibly in regard to how acetyl-L-carnitine may help alleviate the symptoms of depression so rapidly, at least in animals. And possibly inversely, when it's low in the body, leave a person potentially more prone to major depressive disorder in a worst case scenario, treatment-resistant depression. But with all that promising information aside, let's conclude with a further statement from the researchers themselves. And again, The abstract and the DOI citation, we all listed for you to follow. Please keep in mind, though, the full study is a pay-per-view, meaning you got to actually pay to see it. However, that chart I showed you earlier is in the supplemental data, and that is free. To proceed, the big question remains, and this is quoting, she added, we've identified an important new biomarker for major depression disorder. We didn't test whether supplementing with a substance could actually improve patients' symptoms. What's the appropriate dose, frequency, duration? We need to answer many questions before proceeding with recommendations. Yet, this is the first step toward developing that knowledge, which will require large-scale, carefully controlled clinical trials. And with that in mind, here is the abstract, as you may see. I kind of like the idea in regards to the abstract, how it listed acetyl-L-carnitine basically as a, how to describe it, as epigenetic in its effect, per se. So it's really kind of cool on how they look at it as far as how important acetyl-L-carnitine is to the biology as a whole. So DOI would be listed for you to follow information on your own. Really promising study, could offer a lot of help to individuals if it works rapidly and as fast as potentially does in animals, and so on and so forth. I hope you find this information of use. Thank you very much for listening, and look forward to seeing you all again next week. See you next time. Bye.